the edge of the water, long as I can remember, never really knowing why. I wish I could be the perfect daughter, but I come back to the water, no matter how hard I try. Every turn I take, every trail I track, every path I make, every road leads back to the place I know, where I cannot go, where I long to be. See the line where the sky meets the sea, it calls me, and no one knows how far it goes. If the wind in my sail on the sea stays behind me, one day I'll know. If I go, there's just no telling how far I'll go.
Amazing things, too many to count. When I'm in trouble, when I'm surrounded. Hi, friends. It's me, Doc McStuffins. We have a very special birthday, and her birthday is today. Sophia Moihadin from Miss Ashley's class is turning 5 years old today. Take it away, Jake. Come on up, Sophia, to get your birthday picture.
The story of Easter, the triumphal entry. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love and healed people from their sickness. He did many miracles like calming storms and even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
At this time, the Jewish people were celebrating a festival called Passover that had been celebrated since the time of Moses, when God brought his people out of Egypt. So Jesus was going to Jerusalem to celebrate. Jesus and his disciples stopped in a town.
You coming?
And Jesus told two of his disciples to go on ahead of them.
Okay.
He told them to go into a village and that they would see a young donkey that no one had ever ridden.
Rock!
He told them to untie it and bring it to him. If anyone asks, "What are you doing?" he told them to just say, "The Lord needs it and will return it soon."
Okay, go ahead.
So the disciples did what Jesus said and brought him the donkey. A long time ago, before Jesus was even born, God had said that the Savior, the King of Israel, would come to Israel in this way. And now Jesus was doing just as God had said. The news that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem swept through the city. Many heard about all the amazing things he had done, so they cut palm branches and ran to see him.
Huh?
The Pharisees and religious rulers realized that there was nothing they could do, for everyone was going to see Jesus. Jesus rode into the city of Jerusalem, and the crowd spread their coats on the road ahead of him. His followers began to shout and sing as they walked along, praising God for all the wonderful miracles they had seen. The Pharisees were upset.
Hey, Jesus!
And they told Jesus to stop the people from saying things like that. But Jesus said, if they keep quiet, the stones along the road would burst into cheers. So the people kept on singing, "Blessings on the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Praise God in highest heaven." The entire city of Jerusalem was in an uproar as he entered, asking, "Who is this?" And the crowds replied, "It's Jesus." And Jesus rode the donkey through the street of Jerusalem to the temple in a triumphal entry, just as God said he would many years before.
Let's meet Jesus, God's one and only Son. He came to earth to save us, each and every one. Jesus, our King, the very best indeed. One time he rode into the town, sitting on a donkey. Into Jerusalem, for all to see. People cheered and celebrated, waving palm tree leaves, shouting Hosanna, for the King had come that day. It's Jesus from Nazareth of Galilee. He did amazing things, too many to count. Let's all sing it, dance and shout. He did amazing things, too many to count. Let's all sing it. Shout it out! Not Well, after that, Jesus was crucified. He gave himself up on a cross, and then he died. But 3 days later, he rose from that grave. His tomb is empty, and our sins he forgave. He's risen, he is alive. Our Savior, our friend, our King Jesus is A-OK. And now we celebrate Jesus, our risen King, who came to save us, and for this we sing. He did amazing things, too many to count. Let's all sing it, dance and shout. He did amazing things, too many to count. Let's all sing it, shout it. Sing it, shout it.